While Europe's Campi Flegrei Volcano was at a raised alert level of yellow at 1:25 a.m. local time yesterday on March 13, 2025, it generated the largest earthquake this Italian volcano had produced in more than 400 years. While this earthquake only registered in as a magnitude 4.4, lasting for 5 seconds, the damage it caused was more substantial than might be expected. Items fell off of shelves, cracks formed in multiple buildings including apartments, bits of concrete and brick collapsed into structures and fell into streets including notably on some cars, and a ceiling of a building collapsed. In fact, one spot even experienced momentary ground acceleration equivalent to 1.1 times the force of gravity, translating to 10.79 meters or 35.4 feet per second squared. While thankfully, the 1.1 Gs occurred in a spot with no structures, sufficient damage was sadly caused by the brief earthquake that 11 people were injured and multiple buildings had to be evacuated, causing some people to sleep outside. This seemingly severe damage for such a weak earthquake was owed to three factors. Those are the shallow depth of the earthquake, the seismic resonance of the most common height regional structures essentially matching the strongest frequency the earthquake released, and hydrothermal alteration within the caldera greatly amplifying the intensity of ground motion by up to several magnitudes. So, why is all this occurring? While some people are posting doom and gloom claiming a volcanic eruption will soon happen, such claims are pure nonsense and people are worrying about the wrong type of hazard. In my opinion, there isn't even a remote volcanic eruption danger at the present, meaning it isn't going to happen anytime soon unless something unexpected and dramatic changes. However, there might be an actual potential problem revolving around the stability of some structures which could arise due to the risk of more similar magnitude earthquakes striking and continued ground uplift. The damage these magnitude 4 range quakes can cause is self-explanatory based on the recent damage, while for the uplift, let's just say that since the uplift is occurring unevenly, structural problems can arise as most buildings aren't meant to be uplifted unevenly and thus slightly tilted. Now, for reference, each of the following statements are true but are being taken out of context. Campi Flegrei is an active volcano which last erupted in 1538. Yes, Campi Flegrei does have an ongoing magma intrusion that is pushing the ground upwards. There was elevated levels of carbon dioxide gas with a volcanic origin recently detected at a school that caused it to be closed. And finally, yes, Campi Flegrei is at a raised alert level of yellow. However, here's the relevant context. Campi Flegrei has been at a constant raised alert level of yellow since 2016, although elevated activity has been occurring since 2011. Since 2011, an intrusion of magma beneath the Solfatara site has caused magma to slowly ascend from 8 to 3 kilometers depth, from which it then expands into a laccolith-like sill that displaces and domes overlying rock. Related stresses from this uplift are largely accommodated via regional faults, causing increased gas emissions in some spots like was just observed at that school, and earthquakes like the recent magnitude 4.4 event. However, this magma is not advancing any further upwards, and as long as it stays at 3 kilometers depth like it has been doing for 14 years and counting now, it in my opinion won't erupt. Only if magma started shooting upwards above this sill would there be a legitimate eruption danger. However, the aforementioned magma influx and associated uplift are not occurring in a constant manner. Instead, it widely varies, and 3 times since 2023 has produced brief elevated uplift periods where temporarily the amount of ground deformation jumped from what was averaging 10 to 15 centimeters a year to 30 to 60 centimeters a year. Anytime this occurs, larger and more earthquakes occurred alongside them, but the good news is that both prior periods lasted no more than 12 days. At the present, we are in a third such period, which as of today is in its 27th day, involving a rate of 36 centimeters a year of uplift. As a geologist, I am personally expecting this rate to decline once again in the next month, but if that does not happen, this uplift rate is still lower than two periods of unrest, which also did not result in a volcanic eruption in 1950 to 1952 and 1982 to 1985. Now, don't get me wrong. Campi Flegrei is one of the world's most potentially dangerous and explosive active volcanoes during the Holocene, but the good news is that we have fairly confident models that can note in its overall activity cycle where the volcano currently is. At the present, Campi Flegrei is in step 3 of 5, where an elevated rate of ground uplift occurs due to magma rising into the underlying sill. I would only become truly concerned if the rate of ground deformation suddenly spiked to multiple meters a year and stayed there for more than a year, such as when the ground rose by up to 9.4 meters or a whopping 30.84 feet a year in the 2 years preceding its last eruption in 1538. So, unless we add another zero to the end of the current uplift rate, assuming it is maintained, I would in my opinion not worry about Italy's Campi Flegrei volcano erupting anytime soon.